Hi children, welcome to our next science class. Now we are learning lesson 1, plants growing in number. Okay, in this lesson we learn about seed and new plants will grow from the seed. You learned about germination, how does this seeds dispersed and all things you learned. Okay, so new plants will grow from the seed. Then from the seed only new plant will grow? No, other methods are also there. Now we are going to learn about different methods how does a new plant will grow from other part of a plant. Okay, let us start. Which are the different part of a plant? Which are they? Roots, stem, leaf, flower, fruit, seed. Okay, so there are different parts are there. From these stem, roots and leaf, these are the vegetative part of a plant. Okay, these are the vegetative part of a plant. Which are the vegetative part of a plant? Roots, stem, leaves. Okay, and these parts are able to produce a new plants. In some plants these parts will produce a new plants. Okay, so now we are going to learn about these things. How does new plants grow from other part of a plant? Okay, so which are the vegetative part of a plant? Roots, stem and leaves. Okay, so the method of new plants grow from these vegetative parts are called vegetative propagation. Okay, so today we are going to learn about vegetative propagation and different methods of vegetative propagation. Okay, vegetative propagation. Vegetative propagation. Vegetative propagation means what? The method of new plants grow from other vegetative part of a plant. Okay, new plants will grow from vegetative parts of a plant. Okay, first we will study new plants from roots. Okay, new plants from roots. Some plants like carrot, radish, turnip and all, they will produce new plants from their roots. Okay, I will show you. This is a carrot. Okay, actually this is a root of that plant. This part will produce a new plant. Okay, so first one is new plant will grow from root. Okay, in vegetative propagation means the method of growing new plants from vegetative part of a plant. And first we are learning new plants from roots. Okay, first one is new plants from roots. Okay, that means some plants roots will produce new plants. Examples: carrot, sweet potato, radish, turnip. More number of examples are there. Okay, then one activity also there you have to do in your home. In the textbook also one activity is there. Take one sweet potato, but I didn't get sweet potato, so I done with this activity with this carrot. Okay, this carrot placed in a glass, 3/4 of this glass you have to take water. So inside the water you have to put this root of this plant with the help of this toothpick. Okay, then after then it you have to keep in open place because it need sunlight, air. So you have to place it in a open place. After one or few days after we can see it will grow into a new buds also will come from here. Okay, it's a carrot now, so if it is a fresh we can see that here green color we can see. So from there new plant will grow. okay, textbook, you know, textbook also this activity is there. That activity is with a sweet potato. If it is sweet potato is available in your home, you have to do with the sweet potato. Okay, that is an activity for you. You have to do in your home. Okay, so some plants, the roots will produce new plants. Okay, then next we are going to study new plants will produce from underground stem. Okay, now we learned new plants from roots. Now we are going to learn new plants from underground stem. Underground stem means what? Sometimes these stems we can see under the soil. That is why that type of stem is called underground stem. Okay, example, potato. Actually that potato is a underground stem. We can see the potato where we can see under the soil. Okay, this actually it is a stem. Okay, so next we are going to learn new plants from underground stem. New plants from underground stem. Example, potato, ginger. Okay, these stems we can see under the soil. That is why it is called underground stem. And this underground stem is able to produce a new plant. Okay, here if it this is potato, and this outer part of this potato we can see small buds we can see. Okay, then later these small buds will grow into a new plants. Okay, so and these small buds are called eye. Okay, so new plants will grow from the underground stem also. Example, potato and ginger. The outer surface of this potato, ginger and all, we can see small buds or eye, that is called eye. That will later will become into a new plants. Okay, so this is eye. Here we can see the outer surface of the potato. We can see this eye or bud. It will later grow into a new plant. Okay, next. Now we studied new plants from root, new plants from underground stem. Next we are going to learn new plants from stem. Okay, from underground stem, like some plants will produce from stem also. Okay, so third one, new plants from stem. New plants from stem. For example, rose plant. How does we produce a new rose plant? How does? You know that, look here, this is rose plant. This is a stem cutting of rose plant. If we place this rose plant into the soil, after few days we can see small buds also will come in this stem, and it will later grow into a new plant. Okay, so this is called a stem cutting. Okay, so some plants will produce new plants from their stem. Okay, so this for example, rose, not only rose, hibiscus, many examples are there. So how to produce this rose plant into new plant? From the stem cuttings. Okay, this is a stem cuttings, and this stem cutting place into a soil. Then after few days we can see small buds will come. Later this small bud will grow into a new plant. Okay, into the soil it will produce new roots from here, and the leaves will produce their own food. They will make their own food, so it will grow into a new plant. Okay, so new plants grow from stem. Example, what? Rose, hibiscus. These plants are easily available in your surroundings, isn't it? Okay, next we are going to learn how does a new plant produce from leaves. Okay, in some plants leaves also will produce new plants. Okay, so next one is new plants from the leaves. New plants from the leaves. Okay, some for example, bryophyllum. Its Malayala name is ilamulachi. We can see at the margins of the leaf small buds. Okay, I will draw. Here small buds we can see like this. Okay, small buds we can see. Later what will happen if this leaf placed in a moist soil, then these buds will produce a new plant. Okay, for example, which plant? Bryophyllum. Bryophyllum. Okay, so new plants from the leaves, example is bryophyllum. At the margin of the leaf we can see buds. Then if this leaf we can place in a moist soil, then what will happen? These buds will grow into a new plant. Okay, so these are the different methods of vegetative propagation, or these are the plants will produce from other vegetative part of a plant. And one more method is also there. Okay, I will tell you. Now we are going to discuss another method. Okay, all of you look here. This plant is easily available in your surrounding. You just look. I don't know whether now you can visible or not. At the lower part of the leaf, we can see small, small dots we can see. That is called a sori. So this will produce small spores. Okay, and these spores also will grow into a new plants. Okay, so next method is new plants from spores. New plants from spores. New plants from spores. Okay, for example, this plant is a ferns plants. Okay, these plants will produce spores in the lower part of the leaf. Later, if that spore will fall into the soil, it will grow into a new plant. Okay, for example, ferns and moss. Example, ferns and moss. Okay, these are the examples coming under new plants from spores. In their leaf, they will produce small things. Inside that spores are there. That spores will later they will produce new plants. Okay, these are the different methods coming under new plants will grow from other vegetative part of a plant. Okay, so in this class first we learn about what? Vegetative propagation. Vegetative propagation means what? The method of new plants grow from the vegetative part of a plant. Vegetative part, which are the vegetative parts? Roots, stem, leaf. Okay, so vegetative propagation, it is very important. You should study the definition. What do you mean by vegetative propagation? The method of growing plants from their vegetative part of a plant is called vegetative propagation. Okay, first we study new plants from roots. How does a new plants will produce from the roots? In some plants the roots will produce new plants. Example, carrot, turnip, radish. Okay, in these plants roots will grow into a new plant. Okay, next one is new plants from underground stem. Okay, in some plant their stem is grow under the soil. Later this underground stem will produce into a new plants. Okay, example, potato, ginger, and all coming under new plants from underground stem. Underground stem, that means under the soil. These stem will grow under the soil. Later this stem will produce leaves on the upward, then it will grow into a new plant. Next one is new plants from stem. Okay, some plants will produce new plants from their stem cuttings. Example, rose plant. How does we plant a new rose plant? We cut the rose, we cut a small stem from the rose plant, then we will place into the soil. What will happen? That stem cutting will grow into a new plant. Okay, example, rose, hibiscus. So these are the, this is the new plants from stem. Next, after that we learned new plants from leaves. Leaves also, in some plant leaves also will produce new plants. Okay, example, bryophyllum. In the margin of the bryophyllum we can see buds. Okay, this type of structures we can see at the margin of the leaf. And if these leaves we place in a soil, it will, these buds will grow into a new plants. Okay, then last we learned new plants from spores. If the plants like ferns and moss, they will produce zorae in the lower part of the leaves. Inside the zorae we can see tiny spores. If that tiny spore fall into the soil, it will grow into a new plant. Okay, these are the today's topic. You should read and study the textbook thoroughly. Page number 78 and 79, and textbook exercise of this chapter also you have to do in page number 82, textbook exercises from section A to E you have to do in your textbook itself, and read and study these topics. Okay, thank you.